What's going on today, Kyler?
The cadets are doing like a nice ceremony for the veterans for Remembrance Day. So there's going to be a parade going on in Fenelon. This candle is in memory of the veterans that have fought for Canada so that we can be like a brave country.
Well, we're just getting ready for the march, the candlelight march towards the cenotaph, night before Remembrance Day.
Thank you.
No
sovereign and their country. Their sacrifice will ever inspire us to labor on to the end that those who survive and need our aid may be assured of assistance, and that the country in which we live and for which they died may ever be worthy of the sacrifice made. During the silence, we will remember our fallen comrades, our military stations throughout the world, and those who have passed on since we last gathered together. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. Good evening. My name is Arlene Coleman. I'm Poppy and Remembrance Chair of Legion Branch 238. I welcome you to our 16th annual Candlelight Tribute. I would like to introduce our guests with us tonight. Jamie Smith, MP, Lori Scott, NPP, Andy Lesham, Mayor, City of Porthleigh, Stephen Strangway, Councillor, Doug Elmsley, Councillor, Pat O'Reilly, Councillor, and Constable Joan McNichol, RCMP. And our very special guests are veterans. I thank you on behalf of the community.
Great, the gun case.
For the past 15 years, I have stood on this very spot watching the parade arrive at Cenotaph, and my heart just fills with pride in my community, which comes together to pay silent tribute, honor, and acknowledge the debt we owe our veterans. Tonight is no exception. I thank you for keeping the memory alive. To quote Lieutenant Colonel Robert Christopher, it is the soldier, not the reporter, that has given us freedom of the press. It is the soldier, not the poet, who has given us freedom of speech. It is the soldier, not pretentious organizers, who have given us the freedom to demonstrate. It is the soldier, not the lawyer, who has given us the right to a free trial. It is the soldier who salutes the flag and serves under the flag, keeping us free. Tonight, we have candles marking the 100th anniversary of Beaumont Hamel and the horrific losses of the Newfoundland Regiment. The attack, which took place on the 49th anniversary of Confederation, July 1st, 1916, was a devastating failure. In a single morning, almost 20,000 British troops died and another 37,000 wounded. The Newfoundland Regiment was almost wiped out. When roll call was taken the next morning, only 68 men answered. 324 were killed and 386 were wounded. We also pay tribute to our veterans of World War I, World War II, Korea, the Gulf War, Afghanistan, peacekeepers, and Canadian missions around the world. Our veterans have walked through the valley of the shadow of death, and over 100,000 did not return. We also honor those that dared to die, but lived and returned home to build the true North, strong and free. Our veterans know the price of freedom is not free. It is not measured in dollars and cents, but in the hard currency of life, limb, and well-being. The majority of fatalities in war are young men, cut down in their prime. They loved and were loved, and were mourned by friends and family. They never had an opportunity to carve a career, marry, have children, dance with a daughter at her wedding, or welcome the toothless smile of a grandchild. Their sacrifice was monumental. So many died so young, so you and I could grow old in peace. We have a debt we can only repay by ensuring our veterans' efforts, sacrifices, and accomplishments are ever remembered. Our collective remembrance is their everlasting monument to their sacrifices. Our veterans who have passed away since Candlelight 2015. Leonard Arkell. Gus Boyd. Paul Dunn. Jeffrey Godfrey. Dr. William, Doc Bill, Graham. Wilf Martell. Frank Morley. Howard Neal. From where I'm standing, this is an absolute magnificent tribute to our veterans, past and present. I just feel like I'm surrounded by a sea of red, love, and appreciation. For those of you that were concerned, your candles had gone out, rest assured they will be relit for you and burned through the night. Now I'd like to thank everyone for participating by sponsoring candles, marching in the parade, placing candles for those who could not. Local merchants, community service groups for sponsoring candles for the community to carry. I'd like to thank all our fantastic volunteers who make this event possible. Our guests, Jamie Schmale, Laurie Scott, Andy Letham, Doug Elmsley, Stephen Strangway, Pat O'Reilly, John McNichol, and a very special thanks to those veterans that are here with us tonight. Captain Haylock, the Hastings and Prince Edward Regiment cadets and their officers. These young cadets and their officers will remain at the Cenotaph until 11 p.m. this evening.
Sergeant at arms, march off the colors.
Present. Arm.
All parties. Head. Gun. On the left. Quick. Arms.
The business of this gathering being concluded, let us, as we part, remember our duty to our branch, our comrades, and our country, and our sovereigns. May we ever strive to promote unity and the spirit of comradeship, never forgetting the solemn obligations we have assumed as members of the Royal Canadian Legion, and remember them. May we ever pray, Lord God of hosts, be with us yet, lest we forget, lest we forget. Now we will sing God Save the Queen, led by Comrade Fred Walker. March off the colors.